What's up, homies and homettes? It's Ultimate Clayton in the house, and this is Blitzland! And man, so I got the Winter and the Games DS version. In that last episode, we finished up I Speak by doing the rest of his events, and his boss, who was Rugi, backstabbing us and stuff, and says she's sorry. But after we did that and stuff, and released thy last snow spirit, Dr. Eggman and Bowser made away with their freaking Frosty, man. They made away with Frosty, and now we're gonna go rescue him and beat Bowser once and for all in Blitzland. What is this place? It's sort of like a castle under construction. This must be where Bowser is trying to build a castle to control Blitzland. Now that you mention it, I hear Bowser's castle is like this place. It's a combination of, you know, Bowser and Eggman. But look over there! Someone's building somewhere else! Something else. That must be Eggman's base. I can't believe how different it is now. So much for living in harmony with nature. It's sad, Sniff. Let's hurry up and find Frosty. Who knows what kind of traps they set, but we're not going to let them stop us. Yes, let's do this. So this is thy final area of Blitzland right here. Okay, here it goes. All aboard! And when it comes to Blitzland being the final area, it's actually more easy-er. Well, to navigate, actually. It's more easier to navigate and stuff. And the first redstone off the bat is basically at this small spot to the right and stuff where you begin with the white stone. You actually got these three pots, with one of them containing a white stone as well. So, yeah, that's how Blitzland goes and stuff. Blitzland is basically like Frost Town and stuff. Like, it's more straightforward, but then there's like these somewhat little open wide areas. Also, let's talk to this Dark Omo Chow. This Dark Chow. Cha-cha, what do you think you're doing here? Cha-cha-cha, you'll never get the snow spirits back. Never! Cha-cha-cha, Bowser Eggman and Dr. Eggman are indefeatable. Unbeatable. Cha-cha-cha, in fact, you should all just go home right now. I'm not sure I like this Dark Chow's attitude. Yeah, it's Josh Jepson. Better be careful with him. We can't just let Bowser and Eggman keep Blitzland. Cha-cha-cha, look, I'm just trying to help you out here. Turn back. You freaking being Josh Jepson. That again, it sounds like this could be a little dangerous. Yeah, sorry that my voice is like that. Also, because, you know, still sick with the, you know, I'm still sick here. Also, there's your Omo Chow right here and stuff. Now, there's also a bit of puzzling with this, with Blitzland and stuff, for being the final area. Like, there's a couple of puzzles. There's like three, like, areas of this, which is basically the first area right here. There's a gondola, which might take me back to the Frost Town, or back to Kiwi Rift, which will be useful. Then you got this little area with the purple button. You know what happens when you press the purple button? That. So you can actually get through there. So it's little puzzles like that and stuff. There is kind of like a mazy part of Blitzland I will be getting to real late on. So yeah, but overall Blitzland is actually, for it being the final area, is actually more easier than one or two towns we pre-visited and stuff because of how straightforward it is. Like they want you to do this, now go to here and all that stuff. Like yeah, it's not really not open wide as it is. There's your next white stone right here, and we move forward, along with a white stone being at, let me just see, I think there's a white stone right here, and never mind, let's just talk to the penguin. Acidic! Okay, hey guys, you finally made it, I've been waiting forever, how about a round of intense short track, you know what to do. Also, let me just, I didn't even took out my freaking pen. That's what I'm supposed to say. Bowser and Eggman dragged me here and made me do their PR for them. Oh no! So, wait, what? They said I could have all the fish I wanted, but and I believed in them. How stupid am I? I don't think Penguin Rift wants to answer that. Please, if I can't get anyone to play, they won't give me any food. Oh my gosh! So freaking Bowser and Eggman is actually letting these characters who is going to compete on these events with us stay in there. So that means they're slaves! Kanye West was absolutely right, and I copyrighted him on my latest Super Galaxy episode. Super Luigi Galaxy 2 episode. Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. I feel so sorry for these people, because they are the new slaves. Oh my gosh. Also, I totally forgot the event. I think it's Intense Short Track, and Intense Short Track is actually a new event whereas speed types kind of rule. But at the same time, skill types, like you pretty much will get the picture when it comes to the type advantage and stuff. Because basically, like, skill types can be useful, but I'm gonna, like, let me just see here, because it's been a while since I recorded this. You know, I was just gonna do it with Donkey Kong, even though I think it's a stupid idea. Okay, now, basically when it comes to Intense Short Track, instead you just need to do a special dash, which is what they want you to do, by pressing L and R buttons together and finish, like, three times to finish first. Now, the controls for this is that you need to press and release L and R buttons, accelerate, alternate pressing L and R buttons, so sorry that there will be some crazy shirking with my 2DS on my webcam. And to steer is to hold the L and R button, and to curve is the L and R button, to jump is the B button, and to dash is the L and R buttons. Basically, when it comes to the type advantages of Intense Short Track and stuff, is basically the same as Short Track and stuff, where a power type might suck at this, so. But I'm trying to aim for Donkey Kong's metal in this episode, so that's why the hell I'm doing this and stuff. Also, I gotta do it once. But yeah, you also gotta play over here and stuff, like, I can't really remember what this is and stuff. Oh, shoot! Yeah, reason to do the jump and stuff is that. Ugh. Like, I forgot where Intense Short Track is being held at and stuff, because this is an interesting place that I somewhat forgot. Also, just like in, pretty much, just like in Short Track, like, the recovery spots can, like, recover your stuff. Also, I need to literally, keep on. Ugh, my gosh, this is shaking so much. And you also gotta go, like, three laps around. Okay, okay. Man, I'm slow as hell. Okay. Oh my gosh. I'm hugging the wall here. Shoot! Ah! Freaking Mario Kart, yo, except for 8! Come on! Okay, thank you. Come on. I did it like 7 times and stuff. In order to get gold star on this mission, you need to do it like more than 10 times, or I think 12. So be sure to do that and stuff. I only got 3 shots to go, and I'm about to hit the recovery hit. But I'm going as slow as hell. But everybody's still behind me because they are even slower than me as hell, which is weird dick. Weird dick, man. Oh, shoot! Ah! I thought I was like in the finish line and stuff. I need to see my thick dude, I thought he was gonna freaking. Thank you, Ligato. Go! Wow. I thought I was gonna make that. Jeez, that was poor gameplay, Ultimate Clayton. Jeez. Way to protract yourself in the first person to make yourself even more stupid. But at least, even though with that poor, painful gameplay and shaking of my 2DS, that I did it 12 times out of the 3, so I'm bound to get a third gold star unless I also need to do it in faster time, which can be problematic because of my poor, painful gameplay. That wasn't even a new record. Oh, I did. Thought it was supposed to be also at a separate time. Christ, I can't believe that, like, Bowser and Eggman is, like, using everybody who's gonna play against us as slaves. What the hell? Congratulations, you did it. Nothing can stop you now. Why, you can do any mission you set your mind to. I bet Bowser and Eggman are so frustrated they're ready to pop. Then I can slide along home, yes, back to my old fishing grounds or waters. Anyways, yeah, that's basically his mission. We gotta, like, a crystal for and stuff. So let's go back. But yeah, like, I would consider Blitzland like my... I think I would consider Blitzland like my favorite area because of its structure, because... And what's also interesting, for this being this, like, the Winter Games and stuff, Bowser got freaking magma and freaking Blitzland off the rocks and metal. Like, that actually really fits him quite well and stuff, and I am actually curiously interested of how he literally got magma, as usual, on it and stuff, with all of it freaking snowing and stuff, which is nuts. Blitzland was named for the violent blizzards that visited the island. Okay. Also... That was a whitestone over here. There's gonna be something over here, really. But there's three whitestones in this treasure box that you need to visit. Okay, so that's everything over there. Okay, now you got these two pots with a whitestone. Okay. Now, there's also, like, a hidden white stone, like, somewhere near the pipe. The hexagon warp, really. And we also got a heart that is so useless. Yeah, here's your first hexagon warp right here. You can actually activate right now just for hell. So you won't have to forget about it and stuff. And the second hidden white stone in Blitzland and stuff is basically at the bottom left corner near the pipe. And the first hexagon portal in the first area, right here. See? So, yeah. Also, there are actually gonna be, like, there's plenty of pipes in Blitzland and stuff, and they also, like, go inside. They go inside them and stuff, and there'll be, like, ground stuff and stuff. Like, ground... Like, underground stuff, but, like, it's not in this one. And then, like, pretty much after you leave the pipe, there, on the top right corner, near the pipe, you enter the second area, there's a third white stone. So yeah, there's like they're easy to spot white stones and stuff, but at the same time, like, they're also not that much white stones. Like, as a matter of fact, Blitzland is probably known for having the least amount of white stones of all six of the levels and stuff, all six of the areas and stuff. And as a matter of fact, this is our fourth white stone at a level up dead near the maple tree, as you can see there. And at a spot where the pink gondola is on the second area. And this pink gondola might lead to Frostown, I guess. No, Sparkleton, which will be not important since we 100% that place. Or unless Ruby's in there. Okay. And when you go over here, you actually will come across a bit of a dead end that you can actually rock with Sonic. But most importantly, on these freaking boxes! Into a box maze that will lead you to thy good maple tree. And some of these boxes got white stones in them. Haha. So make sure to check these. And some got hearts, which is absolute uselessness. This is not a piece of heart. And there is a white stone. Okay. Well, let's actually open up these. Something. News brief. Blitzland is shattered from snowstorms by the walls of the castle and base. Also, for those who actually even see the beginning of this episode, you do kind of realize a little dress, like a little piece of the dress you kind of saw, and those wintry, girly boots that you pretty much saw and stuff, during like the cutscene showing off Blitzland and stuff. Just take a huge breather of who's really in this final area right now that I totally like. And stuff, cause she's gonna be important, and is gonna be important for thy next episode, and it's gonna be all time awesome. But when it comes to right now, here's your trivia right here. What's Vancouver like? Vancouver is Canada's third largest city, so congratulations to Proton John, and is a famous winter resort spot for all of North America. Its low crime rate and seasonal beauty makes it a pretty comfortable place to visit or call home. And seriously, wow, it's a low crime rate. Okay, E for everyone, y'all. E for everyone, especially to you little rascals who's watching this right now who's like freaking 8 or 5 years old. What the hell, man? Oh, also, you pretty much come over here and you get to these two boxes and stuff. And Omo Chow, right here, if you want to use them and stuff. Then you got this, which will pretty much go through later and stuff, but you can actually just use Sun and R Breakthrough. Got this Toad. Hello there, I'll take over your adventures in Blitzland. A bad and inconvenient going between Bowser's Castle and Eggman's base, huh? You used the left here, haven't you? That's a trick to the left, in case you didn't know. See, if you flip the switch, it takes you to a different space. I admit, it's a little unconfident that the lift and the switch are so far apart, makes you wonder what Eggman, Bowser and Eggman was thinking. Look, I wasn't supposed to say anything about the switch. I can get in trouble. So just, pretend you didn't hear that, okay? Oh my gosh, they're even keeping secrets. What the hell, Bowser and Eggman? You evil hag! Also, if you actually do use that switch, actually, that he was talking about, it changes it sideways. And guess who's on the left side if you change that switch? Daisy! Daisy! So beautiful when your way out if you... Yeah, also, if you, like, use Sonic and stuff. Also, I kinda like her animation when we didn't, like, play a mission. She's literally ballerining, spinning over here. Like, she's freaking awesome, man. Like, look at that. That's just so awesome. Look, it's Princess Daisy. I wonder what she's doing here. I wonder if Bowser and Eggman Oh, no! And actually just took her on their lead. Just think about it. She might be a trap here by Bowser and Eggman. And actually is being used as a sex slave because they're actually... We are the new slaves. As I got MGK running. No, well, not really. I'm just doing some skating in Blitzland. Skating in Blitzland and Bowser and Eggman showed up. Wow. She was just only here for just skating. That's interesting. And she came before Bowser and Eggman and stuff, so it really wouldn't count. They stopped making a castle and base, and now look at this place. Talk about an unpleasant surprise. You tell me. You tell me, woman. Yes, that's quite the tragedy, isn't it? That's okay, though. I've been in hiding, practicing my ultimate figure skating. You're Sonic, aren't you? Pleased to meet you. Also, it's a good thing that we actually talked to Daisy with Sonic, because you get extra texts like this. It's a Mario. Say, can you tell me about the princess there? Oh, what? You mean Blaze? Oh. Are you talking about me, perchance? Fact, I am. I'm Daisy. Who are you? I am Blaze. I'm a prince, and I am a princess in truth in my own world. Jeez, curse you, cop! No, curse you, throat. My sentient throat. God. I thought you were royalty. I'm a princess too. I'm already friends with Peach, and you, we could be the Terrible Three. Also, this is also affecting my Daisy voice, which also sucks. The Terrible Three, also! So when it comes to the Terrible Three, Daisy, you mean, like, you know, like, you also mean that you're, like, the freaking bad A princess and stuff, trying to, like, muzzle with everybody and stuff. Peach literally just don't do nothing, always get kidnapped by Bowser and stuff. And we're just forced to rescue her. Us boys, like we're boys and stuff. Whereas Blaze just burns everything. That's the Terrible Three. Oh my god. Let's celebrate with a round of Ultimate Finger Skating. Do I have to? But yes, in order to let thy Daisy so beautiful to join our team, we need to beat her in Ultimate Figure Skating, which is another new event in thy Blitzland. And we need to beat her on Marin Sonic Melody. And fourthly, with Blaze the Cat herself, which is... Well, I wouldn't say it's horrible and stuff, but it's good with all-around character and stuff. But when it comes to, like, Daisy herself and stuff, as I bust this out and stuff... Like, also to point out, Ultimate Figure Skating is the same as Figure Skating all the ways with all the moves and stuff, except for a few changes. And the type advantages is also the same and stuff. Like, speed types are the same in Figure Skating, but spin more faster. Power types are the same in Figure Skating, with more time to spin. And skill types are the same as Figure Skating, yet with a bit of hitbox on the spinning circle. And when it comes to spinning right here, as we are forced to... Well, as much as I would kind of say that this is, once again, a horrible idea in order to, like, show the freaking performance of them instead of skating right here. I mean, it's Daisy, so this is actually the only one mandatory, like, performance scene mission that is actually worth it. This is just Daisy and not, like, freaking Luigi and stuff and figure skating and stuff. And it kind of gave you an idea of figure skating once you actually tried out, since this is our first time doing figure skating. So, this is the only, like, performance that you can actually just, you know, is forced to see that isn't absolutely horrible and stuff, even though their gameplay is horrible, no offense. Because it gives you an idea of Ultimate Figure Skating being like, since this is your first mission here. And basically, when it comes to spinning stuff, you do have to do that with the stylus and stuff, and, like, literally... Like, you literally have to do that with a stylus and stuff, and, like, spin around and stuff. And then you gotta, like, it builds up your time and stuff, and you need to use it in order to, like, pretty much, you know, hit all those enemies over there. And the more enemies you hit, the more points you get. So that makes sense. Also, ooh, wow. Wow, Daisy's getting screwed. I'm sorry. Oh my gosh. Yeah, also that's a boss in this and stuff, and you gotta do it just like that. Just like Armando's other stuff. Her points will be the same as usual with 2089, which you can beat with her, once again, no offense, horrible performance. And also another difference about Dream Figure Skating, like, intense Ultimate Figure Skating, comparing to Figure Skating that I truly like, is that you can actually go to any, like, tricks that I can do. Like, you can... just screw the coins and go to any trick and stuff. Like, you can start the spin, like, this, like, start the trick like this, jump right here. You can start the jump, like, right off the bat and stuff, instead of going to the spin, like, first, just like Daisy and stuff. Like, you can do that, because you have, like, all those options and stuff. But the path of coins that they show you makes you, like, do the order and stuff, and if you just do the order and stuff, then you can actually just, like... And you literally, like, move the rank with this and stuff instead of, like, going everywhere. So there's two strategies into this and stuff, like, going freestyle off of anything, screwing the coins and stuff. Also, I just screwed this up royally. But I'm not literally gonna show off Daisy again. No offense. I'm just gonna go with the flow. And any coins you actually do miss and stuff, if you actually do, like, the tricks fast enough, like, unlike me, since I just screwed up right there, you do have time before the boss time in order to get the coins that you miss and stuff, so... I only miss like, three of them and stuff, so... I wouldn't cry for it. Also, Marisonic Melody, out of the three songs on Ultimate Dreams Figure Skating... Ultimate Figure Skating, this is actually my favorite right here. Also, oh, no, 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 I need all the time. Oh no! So much for a perfect score. I think it's still easy to get Ghost Star on this. I think I might not be screwed. I literally love this part right here. And that's how it goes. Also, 34,000. That might be enough right there versus like a 2,000. So do I get the gold? Yes, I do. Even though I kind of screwed up royally right there. Awesome. Awesome. And we beat Daisy in the process. Yes, it is, Blaze. You are superior. You can make an awesome group to the terrible three. It's still freaking funny. Crystal! You got a crystal. You didn't. Now you have two crystals. To get rid of the... I saw you got it. Two more crystals. Yeah, like, when it comes... Also, like, when I first actually literally beat Daisy, like, on my first playthrough with this and stuff, I thought she was literally, like, throwing up and stuff, and, like, throwing up and stuff. Like, so I thought she was about to throw up when you literally beat her and stuff, because she lost and stuff. But, yeah, it's basically, like, her losing voice acting right there and stuff. Whoa, ho, ho, ho. Are you okay, Daisy? Are you literally depressed? Are you depressed and stuff? I don't believe it. I lost the Battle of the Princesses after you beat Peach a whole lot of times on Shaka's Charge. Just the luck of the moment. You put up a good fight. Thanks, you really are a princess. Maybe it's time to hang up my skates, though. Say, Princess Daisy, there's no point in you hanging around here every day. Why don't you join us? The child I speak was saying you'd be welcome to come see his flower garden. The flowers are blooming then. I can't miss it. Let's go. Then you, Princess Blaze. Likewise, let's get going. Daisy, join your group. So beautiful, awesome. And Daisy is like, when it comes to Blitzland, Daisy's kind of essential here. And not because of you, Boo-Boo, so much also. She is a cheerful and cheerful, energetic princess of Sarasaland, loves flowers, her accessories have flowerful patterns. Yeah, because everything to her is like a daisy. Because it's her name, man. But also, she is also a new speed type. But at the same time, she is also thy slowest speed type, as you can see here, comparing her to, like, Shadow, Yoshi, and Sonic and stuff, and it's one other character that we'll pretty much get from a while. She is basically, like, the slowest speed type. However, she, like, when it comes to her stats right now, especially her technique in jumping and stuff, as you can see there, she takes kind of the job of a speed type and a skill type at the same time. And this can be useful. Like, this actually can be useful on some occasions of thy skill types, you know, like, advantages and disadvantages on, like, some of the events and stuff. But overall, when it comes to her taking both the job of a speed type and a and a skill type and stuff, like, you know, Peach, like, Silver and Tails and stuff, she's actually a master at either figure skating or ultimate figure skating and stuff. Like, you literally break, like, figure skating and ultimate figure skating, especially with its missions of the two events with her and stuff, so that's freaking hot. But even more important with Princess Daisy, is that she is pretty much, you know, in charge. This is gonna be the biggest throwback in this game that we'll be doing next episode. Because, yeah, sure, Toad said that we literally need to go back at Ice Park Peak in order to, like, visit Daisy to, like, the flower field and stuff with the freeze Aaliyahs and stuff with that challenge stuff. There's gonna be a chain reaction of backtraction when it comes to Princess Daisy and just that and stuff, because there's even more that I gotta do than just visiting the Princess of Sarasaland to freaking flowers. Trust me, you're not gonna miss this. And basically, I said that she is in charge of the biggest backtrack in my game that we're gonna do next episode, because that's the end of this episode. As in this episode, we pretty much introduced that Blitzland and actually, you know, got further through it a bit and stuff. Pretty much, you know, me talking about Blitzland of it actually being more easier than, like, freaking Cubulift, because it's more pinpointed out and what you have to do and stuff, because it's more straightforward. We got Daisy! We got Danger! So freaking beautiful, I gotta say it twice because I suck at life. No, I don't. And we pretty much, you know, found out that Bowser Eggman got an even more evil master plan of using everybody as his slave. Kanye West was truly, truly right. Damn. So in this next episode, we are also going to pretty much, you know, backtrack to Ice Peak and stuff. Basically, this is the part of the game now. This is this little part where it's basically everybody's favorite episode of my LPs called the backtracking episode. Yay! Which we'll do pretty much next time and stuff, okay? Because we're going to backtrack to Ice Peak, which will lead us to backtrack to something else. So if you like this episode, subscribe to my channel, big button, like this video, watch more videos if you can. If you like them too, hit the like button, then be sure to check out my other parts. This has been Ultimate Claim, this has been Super, this has been Man Seven at the Winter Olympic Games, DS Virgin, and I'll see you guys later. Clap Bombers, baby! Peace out, y'all. Oh, yeah!